Okay, good morning to all. So in yesterday's class we are discussing type 3 problems under module 4, that is engineering economics and finance. Type 3 problems. So already we have covered type 1 problem, that is simple interest, problems on the simple interest, and second type, problems on the compound interest. And from yesterday's class, we are discussing type 3 problems. So it means problems on the single payment and uniform series payment. Okay, so far we have discussed 5 problems on type 3. Okay, take a next problem under type 3. Next problem, please all of you look at the slide, the problem number 6. Please all of you look at the slide, problem number 6. See here, if a person borrows rupees 2,50,000, now what uniform amount he is expected to pay every year for the next 7 years in order to repay the capital amount borrowed. Okay, and I is equal to 10%. This is the given data. Okay, I am repeating one more time. See, if a person borrows rupees 2,50,000, now what uniform amount he is expected to pay every year for the next 7 years in order to repay the capital amount borrowed. Okay, so given I is equal to 10%. Okay, so this is compounded annually. Before going to the solution, first we should draw the CFD for the given question or CFD for the given data. Okay, CFD means cash flow diagram. Okay, so this cash flow diagram is made with one horizontal axis. That horizontal axis represents time frame. Okay, that time frame may be in the form of months or years. Okay, and most commonly investments, okay, or outlets are represented in vertical lines below the horizontal axis, and incoming money or incomes or benefits are represented in vertical lines above the horizontal axis. Okay, so first, we should draw the CFD for the given question. Okay, just look at the slide. Okay, so what is this 2,50,000 rupees? A person borrows 2,50,000 rupees. Okay, so is this incoming money or outgoing money? Anybody?
Sir, incoming money.
2,50,000 a person borrows. Okay, initially a person is taking, person is getting 2,50,000 rupees. So this is the incoming money, okay, for the person. So represent this 2,50,000 rupees in vertical lines above the horizontal axis, because here I am showing this 2,50,000 rupees above the horizontal axis. Okay, because this is the incoming money for the person. Okay, initially, okay, in the initial period only, okay, a person is getting 2,50,000 rupees. Okay, so this is the incoming money for the person. Okay, that's why I'm showing this 2,50,000 rupees above the horizontal axis. I'm calling this as P, capital amount. Okay, here in this problem, we have to find what amount of money to be paid by the person in every year for the next 7 years. Okay, here we have to find what amount of money to be paid by the person every year for the next 7 years. Okay, it means we have to find the value of A. Okay, so first year, second year, here the person is repaying some lump sum amount of money, constant amount of money every year for the 7 years. Okay, for the next 7 years, what do you call this constant amount? I'm calling this constant amount as equivalent amount, that is A. A equal to A. Here the A is indicating equivalent amount. It means amount of money to be deposited or amount of money to be invested every year for some period. That is the equivalent amount. Here a person is repaying some constant amount of money for the period of 7 years. Okay. So I'm calling this whole amount of money for the 7 years as a. It means equivalent amount, amount of money to be paid by the person, constant amount of money to be paid by the person for some period. Okay. Here I'm calling this investment as a, because here the person is investing, repaying some constant amount of money every year for 7 years. Okay. So this is the CFD for the given question. Any doubts on this, drawing the CFD for this question? This 2,50,000 rupees is the incoming money. Okay. So initially a person is getting 2,50,000 rupees. This is the income for the person. That's why I'm showing this above the horizontal axis. And first year, the investment in the first year, second year, third year, until seventh year. Okay. So here a person is repaying a constant amount of money for the period of 7 years. Okay. I'm calling this constant amount as a equivalent amount. Okay. Equivalent amount means, okay, that is amount of money to be paid by the person every year for some period. Okay. That is the equivalent amount. So in this problem, our aim is to find the value of A. Okay. Value of A, it means amount of money to be paid by the person every year for the 7 years to return 2,50,000 rupees. Okay. So in this problem, our aim is to find the value of A, and in the question only he has given N as 7 years and I as interest as 10%. Okay. So, and also he has given P, okay, capital amount, 2,50,000 rupees. Okay. So which formula is applicable out of six? Out of six, which formula is applicable? So find A given P. Find A given P. Which formula? Find A given P. Find A given P. Okay, fifth formula, right? Yes or no? Uniform series. Formula on uniform series, capital recovery factor. Okay, this formula is applicable for the sixth question. Okay, so just substitute all the values in the formula. That is formula A is equal to P into bracket I into bracket 1 plus I whole raised to N divided by 1 plus I whole raised to N minus of 1. Substitute all the values in the formula. You will get final answer as 51,351 rupees. Okay, 51,351 rupees. Okay, so it means a person should invest. A person should invest 51,351 rupees every year for the period of 7 years. Okay, to return capital amount of 2,50,000 rupees. So the person should invest every year. A person should invest 51,351 rupees every year for the period of 7 years to return the amount of 2,50,000 rupees. Okay. So this is the solution for the given question. Any doubts on this? Any doubts on drawing the CFD and solution? And this, for every question, the CFD is must and should. Otherwise, they won't give the marks. Go for the solution only after drawing the CFD. In CFD only, you will get some idea about the solution. Okay, the CFD is must and should for the should for every question. Any doubts? Okay, then take a next problem. So, seventh one, see, all of you, please look at the slide. Okay, seventh problem. what amount a person should invest every year in order to get a lump sum amount of 1 lakh rupees at 5 years if the interest rate is 12%. Okay, what amount a person should invest every year, what amount a person should invest every year in order to get a lump sum amount of 1 lakh rupees at the end of 5 years, at the end of 5 years if the interest rate is 12%. Please understand the question. Okay, what amount a person should invest every year in order to get a amount of 1 lakh rupees at the end of 5 years if the rate of interest is 12%. Okay, draw the CFD for this, very simple one. Okay, just what is this 1 lakh rupees, incoming money or outgoing money?
Incoming, sir.
Incoming money. Okay, it means a person is getting 1 lakh rupees at the end of 5 years, right? Yes or no? A person is getting, okay, lump sum amount of 1 lakh rupees at the end of the 5 years. Okay, after a person is getting this 1 lakh rupees after depositing some amount of money every year. Okay, so here we have to find what amount a person should invest every year, amount of money deposited by the person every year for the period of 5 years. Okay, for the after the period of 5 years, the person is getting 1 lakh rupees. Okay, so here we have to find what amount of money deposited by the person every year until 5 years to get 1 lakh rupees. Okay, so 1 lakh rupees is the future sum of money. It means amount of money to be collected after 5 years. Here the person is getting 1 lakh rupees after 5 years, not at the initial stage. Okay, after 5 years the person is getting some amount of money, that is 1 lakh rupees. So I am calling that as F, future sum of money, amount of money to be collected by the person after some period, okay, in future. Okay, that is the future sum of money. I am calling this 1 lakh rupees as future sum of money because the person is getting this 1 lakh rupees after 5 years, okay, not at the initial stage. Okay, so here we have to find amount of money to be deposited by the person every year for the period of 5 years to get 1 lakh rupees with the interest rate of 12%. Okay, so here the person is investing some constant amount of money every year for the period of 5 years. Okay, so this is the constant amount. So here the person is depositing some or investing constant amount of money, equivalent amount of money every year for the period of 5 years. Okay, I am calling this whole cost or investment as A. Okay, A means equivalent amount of money to be invested by the person every year for some period. That is the equivalent amount. Okay, I am calling this whole investment as A because here the person is depositing some amount of money every year for some period. Okay, that's why I am calling this as A. Okay, so here we have to find, in this problem, our aim is to find the value of A or P. Karishma. In this problem, our aim is to find the value of A, equivalent amount of money invested by the person every year for 5 years. Okay, so that is A. Okay, given F, find A. Which formula is applicable out of 6? Okay, find given F, find A. Which one? F is given, find A. Okay, third formula is applicable. Okay, so formula on uniform series sinking fund factor. Okay, formula on uniform series sinking fund factor. This formula is applicable to find the value of A and given F. Okay, then given data are n given, that is 5 years, and I equal to 12%. Substitute all the values in the formula. You will get final answer as 15,740 rupees. 15,740 rupees. Okay. It means a person should invest 15,740 rupees every year for the period of 5 years. Then only he will get the amount of 1 lakh rupees. Okay. What this indicates, 15,740. A person should invest 15,740 rupees every year for the period of 5 years. Okay, then only he will get 1 lakh rupees after end of 5 years. Okay, so this is the solution for this question. Very simple one. Any doubts on this from anybody? Pallavi, Sushma, then Nagraj, Balchandra, Naushin. Any doubts on seventh problem? Balchandra, Ambika.
No, sir.
No? Okay. Then take a next one. See, eighth one. All of you look at this slide. Problem number eight under type 3. See, Mr. Arun brought a car making an initial payment of rupees 1 lakh and taking the loan of rupees 1,50,000 from ICFC Bank. Okay, I'm repeating one more time. Mr. Arun brought a car making an initial payment of rupees 1 lakh and taking the loan of rupees 1,50,000 from ICFC Bank. Okay. He makes the equal monthly repayment. He makes the equal monthly repayment of 8,000 rupees to ICFC Bank to clear the loan of period of 2 years. Okay, to clear the loan of period of 2 years. Okay, after making the last payment, he sells the car for rupees 1,50,000. After making the last payment, he sells the car for rupees 1,50,000, draw 2 CFDs. Okay, one for Mr. Arun and other for ICFC Bank for the above cash flow. Okay, just in this problem, he is asking only to draw the CFD. Okay, he is asking to draw the 2 CFD, one CFD for the Mr. Arun and another one for the ICFC Bank. Okay, he is not asking any solution. He is asking only to draw the CFD for 2 cases, one for Mr. Arun and another one for ICFC Bank. Okay, please, all of you look at this slide and read the question and understand carefully. Okay, read the question and understand it. Okay, I am repeating one more time. See, Mr. Arun brought a car making an initial payment of rupees 1 lakh and taking the loan of rupees 1,50,000 from the ICFC Bank. He makes the equal monthly repayment of 8,000 rupees to the ICFC Bank to clear the loan of period of 2 years. After making the last payment, he sells the car for rupees 1,50,000. Draw 2 CFDs, one for Mr. Arun and another one for ICFC Bank for the above cash flow. Okay, he is asking only to draw the 2 CFD, one for Mr. Arun case, another one for ICFC Bank. Okay, he is not asking any solution, just he is asking to draw the CFD for Mr. Arun case and ICFC Bank case. Okay, so all of you please read the question and understand it. Then only easily you can draw the CFD. Read the question and understand it. Okay, see, first take a Mr. Arun case. Okay. See, Mr. Arun brought a car and initial payment of rupees 1 lakh. This is incoming money or outgoing money for the Mr. Arun? This 1 lakh rupees, incoming money or outgoing money for the Arun?
Outgoing.
Okay. It means he in the initial stage only, Mr. Arun is investing 1 lakh rupees. Okay. So, show this 1 lakh rupees below the horizontal axis. Okay. I am showing this 1 lakh rupees below the horizontal axis. Okay. Because this is the investment from the Mr. Arun in the initial period. Okay. In the initial period only, he is investing 1 lakh rupees. Okay. 1 lakh rupees. That's why I am showing this investment below the horizontal axis. And one more time, at the same time, he is taking the loan of 1,50,000 rupees. Is it incoming money or outgoing money for the Mr. Arun? Don't compare this with ICFC Bank. Okay, just take the Mr. Arun case. At the same time, he is taking a loan of 1,50,000 rupees. Is it incoming money or outgoing money for the Mr. Arun?
Incoming.
Yes, because he is getting some amount of money, that is 1,50,000 from the bank, from ICFC Bank. Okay, so this is the 1,50,000 rupees is the incoming money for the Arun. That's right, I am showing this vertical line. Okay, 1,50,000 vertical line above the horizontal axis. Okay, so any doubts on these two, 1 lakh rupees and 1,50,000 rupees? Showing the arrows below and above the horizontal axis. 1 lakh rupees is the investment from the Arun. At the same time, he is getting 1,50,000 from the bank. Okay, in the initial period only. Okay, so and after this, he makes the equal monthly repayment of 8,000 rupees. Okay, here the Arun is repaying the money every month for the period of 2 years. Okay, here the Arun is repaying the money in every month for the period of 2 years with an amount of 8,000 rupees. It means Arun is repaying 8,000 rupees every month for the period of 2 years to the ICFC Bank. Okay, so is it investment or incoming money or outgoing money? This 8,000 rupees for the period of 2 years. 8,000 rupees. Is it incoming money?
Outgoing money.
Okay, so here I have divided. You have to divide this horizontal axis into how many number of months? Because here Arun is repaying the money in every month. Okay, for the period of 2 years. It means divide the horizontal axis into how many number of months? 24, no? Because the total period is 2 years. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 10, 11, 12. 12 is nothing but here 1 year. I am showing this 12 as 1 year because here the Arun is repaying the money, repaying 8,000 rupees in every month for the period of 2 years. Okay. So what is this 8,000 rupees? A or P or F?
A.
A, because Arun is depositing or investing constant amount of money every month, okay, for the period of 2 years. Okay, so that's why I am calling this as A, equivalent amount of money to be deposited or invested every month or every year for the period, for some period. Okay, so this 8,000 rupees is the A. Okay, and also 8,000 rupees to ICFC Bank to clear the loan of period of 2 years. After making the last payment, he sells the car for rupees 1,50,000 rupees. Okay, it means after making the last payment, he sells the car for rupees 1,50,000 rupees. It means after 2 years, Arun sells the car for the rupees of 1,50,000 rupees. Then what do you call this 1,50,000, incoming money or outgoing money for the Arun?
Incoming money.
Okay. So this is after 2 years. Okay. Last payment, after making the last payment means after 2 years, Arun is selling the car for rupees 1,50,000 rupees. So this is the incoming money for the Arun. Okay, hence I am showing this 1,50,000 rupees after 2 years. Okay, after 2 years above the horizontal axis. So this is the CFD for Arun case. Any doubts on this?
No, sir.
No? Okay. So this is the CFD for the Arun case. Then take a same question, same data, draw the CFD for ICFC Bank. Consider only incoming and outgoing money from ICFC Bank. Draw the CFD for ICFC Bank. Okay. See, this is the CFD for ICFC Bank. Just look at the slide. Is it visible to everyone? This slide? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then draw the CFD for ICFC Bank. Okay. Consider only incoming money and outgoing money for the ICFC Bank. Okay. First, Mr. Arun brought a car of initial payment 1 lakh rupees. Okay, this is with Arun case. Taking the loan of 1,50,000 rupees. See, the Arun is getting 1,50,000 rupees from the ICFC Bank. For ICFC Bank, this 1,50,000 rupees is incoming money or outgoing money? For ICFC Bank.
Outgoing.
Outgoing money for ICFC Bank. Don't consider Arun case. Okay. For ICFC Bank, this 1,50,000 rupees is the outgoing money because the Arun is getting 1,50,000 from ICFC Bank. Okay. So this 1,50,000 rupees is the outgoing money for ICFC Bank. Okay. So the arrow mark or vertical line should be below the horizontal axis because this 1,50,000 rupees is the outgoing money or investment for the ICFC Bank. Okay, that's why I'm showing this vertical line below the horizontal axis. Any doubts on this? 1,50,000 rupees. Consider only ICFC Bank outlets and incomes. Okay, next, read the question. Loan of 1,50,000 rupees from ICFC Bank. He makes the equal monthly repayment of 8,000 rupees to ICFC Bank. Okay. So this 8,000 rupees is associated with ICFC Bank, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. For ICFC Bank, this 8,000 rupees is income or outlet?
Income.
Yes. Here, the ICFC Bank is getting 8,000 rupees from Mr. Arun in every month for the period of 2 years. Okay. This 8,000 rupees is the incoming money for the ICFC Bank. Okay. So monthly, in every month, the ICFC Bank is getting 8,000 rupees. In every month, ICFC Bank is getting 8,000 rupees for the period of 2 years. Okay. Show like this. Okay. So every month. Okay. Here, the every month, the ICFC Bank is getting 8,000 rupees for the period of 2 years. Okay. So consider this whole amount. Consider this whole amount as a equivalent amount, 8,000 rupees, because the bank is getting equivalent amount or some constant amount of 8,000 rupees for the period of 2 years. Okay. So that's why I'm showing these arrow marks or vertical lines above the horizontal axis. Okay. So here the bank is getting 8,000 constant amount in every month for the period of 2 years. Okay. So, continue. See, loan of period of 2 years. After making the last payment, he sells the car for 1,50,000 rupees. So, this 1,50,000 rupees, last payment, he sells the car for 1,50,000 rupees. This is not associated with ICFC Bank. Okay. So this 1,50,000 rupees is associated with Arun, okay, not with ICFC Bank, okay. So So this is the CFD for the ICFC Bank. Okay, in this problem, he is asking only to draw the CFD for Arun Caves and ICFC Bank. Okay, he is not asking any solution. Okay, so any doubts on this problem from anybody? Nagraj, Balchandra, Daneshwari?
No, sir.
Jinendra, Yellappa, Arun, Muttu, Vinayaka? No, no. Then Vinayak Kamble, Pallavi. Aishwarya?
No, sir.
No. Spurtika?
No, sir.
Okay. So, this is the last problem on third type under module 4. So, from next class, I will start the type 4 problems. Type number 4. Okay. So, any doubts on these problems? Totally. I have solved 7-8 problems here on third type. So if you have any doubts on third type problems, then you can ask. And this, before going to the solution, this CFD is must and should. Otherwise, they won't give the marks. And after drawing the CFD, you will get some idea about the solution. Okay. The solution becomes very easy after drawing the CFD for the given question or given data. If you have any doubts, then please ask. Okay, please put the USN number in chat box.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So what's the portion for second IA?
Second IA. Yesterday, nimge idralli second first IA ke portion 1.5 alva.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Nan text martini. Group al text martini. Portion helti.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay, please put the USN number in chat box. And be in line for 1 minute. Okay, thank you. You can leave the class now. And from tomorrow class, I will start the next type problems. type number 4 under module 4.